Hi, everybody. Dave Winder here, and here's what's coming up today on the Racer Report as the Racers win an overtime thriller 35-34 at Jacksonville State. We'll talk about the Racers' first ever win at JSU, the overtime strategy, and all three Racer interceptions on the day. We'll get you ready for the Racers coming home this weekend to take on Tennessee Tech at Stewart Stadium. And, of course, the best calls from the voice of the Racers, Neil Bradley. The Racer Report begins right now. And that will bring us to this week's game as the Racers are coming back home to take on Tennessee Tech. 3 o'clock kick in the afternoon on Saturday at Stewart Stadium. Folks, plan your week around it and be here for a big, big game Saturday as the Racers try to go to 2-0 in the OVC. Hi, everybody. Dave Winder here along with head coach Chris Hatcher. He's got a smile on his face. Instant classic, coach. An overtime victory at Jacksonville State. First ever win for the Racers at JSU. Murray State's first win against the Gamecocks since 2003. How are you feeling on Saturday afternoon?
Well, it was a great day for our football team. We've played really well against Jacksonville State in the 3 years I've been here, but to come up short each and every time, to go on the road, OVC opener versus a team that had beaten your school nine straight times, and to win in the way, in the fashion that we won in, to show the resolve, fight through the adversity, and find a way to win. Great testament to our team, great testament to our coaches. It was just a great win. It's the biggest win of my tenure here, and we were talking before the show. There's a lot of arguments to be made, but it could be one of the bigger wins that this program's had in a long, long time.
Perhaps, maybe, since the year the Racers won it last time, 2002, so it's been a long, long time. So let's roll the highlights and take a look at it. Going down to Jacksonville, Alabama, as the Racers took on the Gamecocks on a beautiful Saturday afternoon. Coach, you got to love day football. I love it.
No, there's no question. It had a collegiate feel to
it. Sure did.
Had almost 15,000 people at the game. And we ended up getting the ball first and didn't do a whole lot. They came out and played us a lot of man coverage to try to take away our quick screen. So we were forced to punt early on. I thought that Steven Mix did an outstanding job of kicking the football. We covered extremely well.
And then they punted right back.
Yeah, and our defense, I thought our defense really, really played good. We ran out of gas there at the end. But, it was a big day for us rushing. I think we had 59 rushing attempts and 85 plus snaps, which is very unusual for us. Here you can see Jamal Berry breaking out of there with a nice run. You got to give credit to our five offensive linemen. They blocked extremely well all night. But that was our game plan, Neil. They were going to play a lot of three-man front. We knew we were going to have to run the football. We pick up a very key first down to Walter Powell, who was held only four catches on the day.
Yeah, you could tell they were certainly going to concentrate on him. But, Coach, you talk about running the ball. This is probably the best rushing game that you've had since you've been here, for sure, right?
Well, it's close to it. Yeah. We've had some. Old Mike Harris had some big games pretty much all by himself.
Right, yeah.
But, this was by design. I mean, like I said, I knew going in, and Coach Stewart knew going in, if they were going to play us this away, we were going to have to be good at running the football. So we get a good drive going here. Just a very poor decision by our quarterback. Should have kept the ball outside, either throw it away or run it. Don't really know what we were thinking there. So our drive, it stalls. We end up getting backed up, and we're forced to kick a field goal, but it sure was good to see Jordan Benton knock it through.
That's right. Good from 40 yards. Murray stayed up 3-0 with 9:20 to go in the first quarter. Now go ahead to 5:09 left in the first quarter. And take a look at that. That's a career-best 66-yard punt by Stephen Mix down at the 1 yard line by Davis.
Well, great punt, and Janowski did an awesome job of pinning them inside the one. And you know, you got to use those teams as a weapon, and we were able to do that, flip the field position. You know, at this point of the game, I feel like we got a lot of momentum. Our defense is playing outstanding offensively. We're able to run the ball at will. And as you can see, Jamal Berry, another big run. You know, him and Dwayne really ran the ball hard. And Mikael Miller had 124 yards rushing on the day. So here we go. We end up scrambling out. We find Walter Powell. I mean, as we well know, he gets close to end zone. He finds a way to get in there with the PAT. We're up 10-0 and feel really good about where we're at this point of the game.
And that's how the first quarter ended, with the Racers enjoying that 10-0 lead. Now we're going to move to 4:27 before the half. Coach, you guys are driving. Miller hits Powell right there, 9 yards to about midfield. And then Miller just had a really good knows for when to take off with it and when to go ahead and throw it.
Yeah, a lot of those were designed quarterback runs. And, you know, we get down here close and on a third and goal. We actually called timeout. We had it first or third and goal from the one. We got a penalty. And Dwayne Brady said, hey, let's run this play. And it worked to perfection. So it was good for us to get it in the end zone and not have to settle for a field goal.
So they kick it off with it's under 1:30 to go. You guys have great coverage on the kickoff, first of all.
Yeah, that was T-Ray Malone and Carson Greifenkamp had a great kick. And, you know, right here, I think, you know, we're up. I believe the score is
it's 20-10.
20-10 at this point, okay.
Right.
And they get a great drive with a minute and a half to go in the ball game. And
here's another look at that play there.
Yep, and they get it down, and just a great strip by Brandon Wicks. And we're able to recover the ball with 1 second to go in the half. And you talk about a big momentum swing. Instead of going in 20-17, we're up 20-10. And that proved to be the difference in the ball game.
It certainly was. And then there again, you got to realize that JSU was going to get the ball first to start the second half. So a huge play by Brandon Wicks. We're at the half. Racers up 20-10. We'll show you the second half when we come back in a moment here on the Racer Report.
The thoroughbreds we are named for, Racers are spirited and proud. We have the heart and will to succeed, to go farther, learn more, and embrace wisdom. We are champions who take our place in the Murray State tradition. We are Racers.
Enough of this golf already.
How much of the golf?
Golf's stupid.
You're stupid.
Boys, settle down. At Time Warner Cable, any of these devices can be your TV at the click of a button. No one offers more sports on more devices than Time Warner Cable.
Why, have you got a laptop?
I want the cell phone.
Give me that laptop.
Call 1-855-WANT-TWC and ask how you can save up to $600. Switch to a better entertainment experience guaranteed. Time Warner Cable. Enjoy better.
Roof Brothers, a Paducah tradition for 100 years. Roof Brothers, locally owned, family run. Roof Brothers, the best selection of beer, wine, and spirits found anywhere. Roof Brothers, service from selecting that special beverage for that special occasion to a keg party at the lake. Roof Brothers, two locations to serve you. Roof Brothers, proud supporters of Murray State Athletics.
Hi, folks. Welcome back to the Racer Report with head coach Chris Hatcher. Murray State up 20-10 at the half. Let's roll the second half tape and take a look at it from Jacksonville, Alabama. As the Racers, we mentioned, you had to give JSU the ball. They deferred, so they got the ball first to start the third quarter.
And we get great coverage here. You know, we got a bunch of guys running down. Janowski Davis is the first guy down, and Brandon Wicks makes the tackle. But very disappointed. We didn't come out with as much intensity as they did. You got to give them credit. Running back was outstanding all night, a tough load to bring down. So they cut the lead to 3 early on. And they made a good adjustment at the half. They put more guys in the box, switched their coverages up a little bit. So we end up getting a pretty good punt right here. And we Almost. Probably could have got it. Actually, that guy shouldn't have been able to block our man there. So that was kind of disappointing. But we get a big turnover. We ended up forcing 4 on the night. John Thorell picks off the ball here off of a tip. And we get an opportunity to go back to work on offense. And I thought a couple times offensively, with the way how opportunistic our defense was, Dave, that we had some chances to really put the game away and never could do it. And that was a little disappointing, especially as we head on into the fourth quarter.
Well, when you think about it, Mix had 6 punts for almost a 43-yard average. And there goes Jamarcus James again. That guy, what a load he is to try to bring down.
Well, it was 4th and short, and we ended up overplaying to the side he always runs to, and sometimes you get those creases on the backside. But we held him out of there twice, and the third time he knocked it on in, and then all of a sudden, boy, any momentum we had, they have it now.
That's right. So the Racers lead cut to 24-20 with 4:06 to go in the third. And you made them punt from their own end zone.
Here. Yeah, I thought special teams wise we played well, and you know we're really right here. We're really close to having a big time play here, and Walter does a good job getting it down. And you know we're here in the fourth quarter, and we got to get something going. We were held out, shut down
in the third quarter.
Didn't get any points. But again, our defense. I thought they were starting to get a little tired at this point. They'd played a lot of snaps. Good pass to Janowski Davis from Mobile, Alabama. He wanted to play good in front of the home folks. Nice run here. Again, that offensive line's pounded them. Jamal Berry. This was our best drive of the second half. Here we fake the screen, run the draw. We're converting fourth down. We were good on fourth down all night, and we were a little bit better on third down than we have been in the past.
And there's your quarterback run.
Yep, fourth and a half yard. We punch it on in. The extra point is good. And all of a sudden, we're up 3 and got a little momentum back in our favor.
That's right. So after Jacksonville had come back and got the lead for the first time, the Racers regained the lead. Quay Hussey right there in the right spot, made a great pick. And, you know, for a second here, I thought he might take it all the way back.
Well, it would have been big.
Here's another look at it.
I tell you, this is the second one.
Oh, that's the second one.
Yep, we ended up intercepting. Offense couldn't get anything going. And now Josh Manning intercepts one. We got 6 minutes on the clock here, Dave. Here's another look. Ball on the 25-yard line. And all we got to do is score a touchdown and the game is over. But we just couldn't get much going. This was the first down run, so now we're 2nd and 5.
So now you got to kick the field goal.
Yep, we go for the field goal
and
we miss it. I was trying to make it at least where they had to score a touchdown to drive it down the field. And at this point, you know, we're just holding on, and our defense again had played a lot of snaps, and they bust through, get a couple big runs. You can see we have a host of guys there trying to make the tackle. We end up, they convert a couple third downs. We miss a couple tackles. And fortunately for us, they let it run down, call timeout, settle for the field goal. And you can see right here on the left where they didn't show it, but Travis Taylor almost blocks it. So we go into overtime, and it's very ironic. The last time, well, here it is. The last time Jacksonville State had been beaten overtime was when Murray State beat them in 2003.
In 2003, and this was Jacksonville State's third straight overtime game, which is just crazy, but we're at the end of regulation now. It's 27-27, and we'll show you the overtime when we come back with Coach Hatcher here on the Racer Report.
Roof Brothers, a Paducah tradition for 100 years. Roof Brothers, locally owned, family run. Roof Brothers, the best selection of beer, wine, and spirits found anywhere. Roof Brothers, service from selecting that special beverage for that special occasion to a keg party at the lake. Roof Brothers, 2 locations to serve you. Roof Brothers, proud supporters of Murray State Athletics.
Enough of this golf already.
I'm with you to golf.
Golf's stupid.
You're stupid.
Boys, settle down. At Time Warner Cable, any of these devices can be your TV at the click of a button. No one offers more sports on more devices than Time Warner Cable.
Why, have you got a laptop?
I want the cell phone.
Give me that laptop.
Call 1-855-WANT-TWC and ask how you can save up to $600. Switch to a better entertainment experience guaranteed. Time Warner Cable. Enjoy better.
I go because my friends are here.
I go because it's so close.
I go
for the small class sizes.
I go
to get a better job.
I go because
I can take classes when it works for me.
I go because I can transfer my credits.
I go for some of Kentucky's most affordable tuition.
I go because it's crazy not to.
For all the right reasons. The Kentucky Community and Technical College System. Higher education begins here.
Doing? It's summer. Let's hit the beach.
Mom?
You need a Pepsi.
Ooh. Mm.
Let's have some fun.
Woo! All right.
Summertime is Pepsi time. You gotta work on that tan, bro.
We're back here in the Race Report with head coach Chris Hatcher. We're going into overtime, 27-27 at Jacksonville State. So let's go ahead and roll the overtime here, Coach. You guys won the toss. You wanted to be on defense second.
Yep. Well, we chose defense first. That way, you get the choice. They chose to play down and they're closed in. And you know, I knew we were tired. They had that last drive. They had run it down the field on us, and they come right out. And it didn't take them long.
Two plays.
To punch it on in. We're missing tackles. Something that we hadn't done all game long. So, again, they got the old Mo on their side. Things aren't looking good for us. And they knock it through, and they're up 7 points in a hurry.
That's right. So it's 34-27. Now, you're going to watch here twice, Coach, on this drive. You convert fourth downs. The first one is we'll see in just a minute. The first one was a fourth and 10.
Well, we tried the screen to Brady on play one, and they sniffed it out pretty good. We hadn't run it all game. And again, I mean, they're fired up. And we run the ball in the middle of the field. We try to throw it down the field to Walter. Almost gets picked. Thank goodness it didn't. So It's fourth and 10, game on the line. Right here, we've been here before, Missouri State. And we're trying to throw the ball backside to Walter Powell. Jeremy Harness catches it. Gets the first down. Great teaching moment for our team.
Another look at it,
yeah,
Coach.
We tell our guys, hey, just tell the QBs, throw it to the guy that's open and let him get it after the catch.
You know, Coach Harness made a great play to come and get that ball.
Oh, he played extremely well. So here we're trying the halfback pass. Thought we had set it up, but they play it well. I mean, I tell you what, they got a great defense. You got to give them credit. Very good football team at Jacksonville State. So here's a good run by Mikhail. Again, another quarterback draw. And you can see it here. This is a second down play.
Good blocking out in front of him, too.
And, our guys are competing hard, which we had no problem with all night, being competitive. Right here.
Another yard.
Yep, and we're short. We're about, I think we're just a half yard
now
short.
It's fourth and one.
Yep, and we're able to get it on the quarterback sneak, so we inching a little closer. Of course, everybody's on their edge of their seats.
And then here, Coach, this is the touchdown. Little number 23 jumped in there, and somehow you see Mikhail kind of slide out from underneath the pile. I don't know how he got through there, but he got through for the touchdown.
Well, he did. If you see it from the other view, with that our film view that we watch, is there. So we decided to go for two.
Now, were you? Was there a possibility for the point after?
No, we had decided to do that, and we had a special play called before, and they sniffed it out, and so we called timeout. We have one timeout in overtime. So we changed the play, and I think that took them a little off guard. I think they're thinking, well, they're going to go kick, and we run a little bootleg or a little sprint out to the right, and we find Jeremy Harness in the end zone for the win. And what a great feeling to get that monkey off our back to beat Jacksonville State. First time that as a player, a coach, that I had ever been on a team that beat Jacksonville State. And they end up running into Walter, and Janowski Davis did a nice job, and you can see it again. Boy, you're talking about a great feeling right here. It was a very special moment for our football team to be able to overcome that type of adversity, win on the road against an undefeated team, the perennial power in our league.
Yeah, just a great, great day. And a coach says many, many times, it's nothing like a Saturday night as a Racer after a big win. And
yep.
The bus ride home must have been, it's long, but it must have been fun to come home.
Well, it beats the alternative.
Right.
And, you know, I've been in that situation before where we've gone for two and didn't make it, and they booed me out of the stadium. but this time it worked, and I'm very proud of our guys. They played a well of a ball game, well-deserved team victory. Defense, offense, and the special teams all played well. Just a great night for our football program.
All around great win, 35-34 for the Racers. We're going to take another break here from Miller and Harness, who hooked up on that two-point conversion. We'll do that next on the Racer Report.
I go because my friends are here.
I go because it's so close.
I go for the small class sizes.
I go
to get a better job.
I go because
I can take classes when it works for me.
I go because I can transfer my credits.
I go for some of Kentucky's most affordable tuition.
I go because it's crazy not to.
For all the right reasons. The Kentucky Community and Technical College System. Higher education begins here.
Hey, ladies. Enjoying the film? Of course not. Because this is our movie! And Dr. Pepper 10 is our soda. It's only 10 manly calories, but with all 23 flavors of Dr. Pepper, it's what guys want, like this. Catchphrase.
So you can keep the romantic comedies and lady drinks. We're good.
Dr. Pepper 10, it's not for women.
10 seconds to go. Coming forward. Moves in top of the key. 6 seconds to go. The three.
Enough of this golf already.
How much of the golf?
I'm stupid.
You're stupid.
Boys, settle down. At Time Warner Cable, any of these devices can be your TV at the click of a button. No one offers more sports on more devices than Time Warner Cable.
Why have you got a laptop?
I want the cell phone.
Give me that laptop.
Call 1-855-WANT-TWC and ask how you can save up to $600. Switch to a better entertainment experience guaranteed. Time Warner Cable. Enjoy better.
Hi, folks. Welcome back to the Racer Report. By now, in the last segment, you've already seen that two-point conversion, but we're going to show it to you again as the Racers go for the win at Jacksonville State. Kudos to Coach Hatcher, and he'll join us in just a moment. But take a look at that play. Two-point conversion, you either win it or you lose it on one play. The Racers got it done, and afterwards, the two guys that pulled it off, Mikhail Miller and Jeremy Harness, talked about the big play as the Racers get a big win at JSU.
Only thing going through my mind is it's time to make a play. Like I said, we called a play kind of similar to that earlier in the day, and I knew that it was going to be wide open. So as we were going through the play, I knew it was just going to be wide open. I just knew I just had to make a play.
I was surprised at first, but I knew they had a couple of calls that they liked and they saw earlier in the game, and they thought we could get that play at the end, and we did.
Well, you hear Harness and Miller talk about the play, but Coach, that kind of thing is honed by repetition and practice. And when you get into that spot, you hope that you execute just like you did in practice.
Well, you're exactly right. And I thought we rep that an awful lot this week. In fact, one day I'm out at practice and I'm going, golly, boy, we sure are working on this play a lot more than we normally do. And it worked to perfection. Our guys, they stayed focused there in that overtime period. They converted a good bit. And, you know, actually, it was an easy call to make. We were really tired on defense, and we were having trouble moving the football. We had only had one good drive the entire second half. Had to convert two fourth downs. Got a 50-50 chance, and fortunately for us, we executed the play like it's supposed to be executed. And, you know, I always say great players make great plays in big-time games, and some of our playmakers really came through down the stretch.
They certainly did. So that'll take us to this week, Saturday, 3 o'clock against Tennessee Tech. We want you to be in the stands at Roy Stewart Stadium. Look forward to that. And we'll take our final break here with head coach Chris Hatcher and come back and wrap it up here in just a moment on the Racer Report.
Enough of this golf already.
I'm with you, the golf.
Golf's stupid.
You're stupid.
Boys, settle down. At Time Warner Cable, any of these devices can be your TV at the click of a button. No one offers more sports on more devices than Time Warner Cable.
Why, do you got a laptop?
I want the cell phone.
Give me that laptop.
Call 1-855-WANT-TWC and ask how you can save up to $600. Switch to a better entertainment experience guaranteed. Time Warner Cable. Enjoy better.
Roof Brothers, a Paducah tradition for 100 years. Roof Brothers, locally owned, family run. Roof Brothers, the best selection of beer, wine, and spirits found anywhere. Roof Brothers, service from selecting that special beverage for that special occasion to a keg party at the lake. Roof Brothers, two locations to serve you. Roof Brothers, proud supporters of Murray State Athletics.
Back here to wrap it up with head coach Chris Hatcher. Don't forget the Racers at home against Tennessee Tech. Murray State hadn't started 2-0 in the OVC since 1998. They got a chance to do that Saturday. Coach, Tech is a good ball club coming in here, but more than anything, we need a big Racer crowd out Saturday. Come
we
out
do.
Tailgate.
We do. Every OVC game is of the utmost importance. Tennessee Tech's playing well. They're well coached. Big rival of ours, as they all are. Mm-hmm. We do. We need a big crowd. We need a home crowd. And, you know, I don't know. You know, everybody needs to understand the magnitude of that win last week was big. That was a huge win, not only for this team, but just for our program in general. So come out and support the Racers. We need you at the track Saturday at 3.
Okay, we'll look forward to it. Coach, congratulations again.
Thank you, Dave.
Great day to be a Racer. We'll leave you, and as we leave you today, the voice of the Racers, Neil Bradley, he had a good day too.
Empty backfield for Mikhail Miller. Harris Bibben snaps it back to him. Miller looks right, throws across the middle. He's got Powell. He's at the 15, 10, 5, and he's gone for the touchdown. Wayne Brady standing to his right. They send a man in motion. Now back this way. It's a handoff to Brady. Up the middle for the touchdown. They fooled everybody.
Dwayne Brady with the drag in the feet steps into
Miller,
the end zone.
Miller, empty backfield, runs it up the middle. Cuts to the outside. 5, 10. He's into the end zone. Hit the 5 into the goal line for the score, Mikhail Miller. A 12-yard touchdown run. One back in there. That is Brady standing to the left of Mikhail Miller. Miller looks across the middle. He's still looking. Throws for Harness. He catches at the 15, down to the 13, 12. Make it the 13, and it is a first down. What a big catch and run by Jeremy Harness. So the Racers have the ball. First and goal at the 1. Miller carries it. He has it for the
touchdown.
Mikhail Miller, man in motion is Harness. Miller rolls right, looks, throws, caught by Harness, he scores! The Racers score! The two-point conversion is good! Miller to Harness, and the final, the Racers 35, and Jacksonville State 34. The Racers celebrate outside the end zone.